I'm looking forward to it, Frankie. I love checking out music whenever, like, the actual artist is in the stream with us. Never mind. I thought this was going to be rap. It's not. This is country.
I got turned around country. Some little town I'd never been to before, working my way through the middle of June midnight thunderstorm. There was something in the headlights that stopped me on a dime. Well, she was scared to death, so I said climb in.
Yo, I am digging his vocals, and I like the vibe of it. And, man, this music video, he's talking from behind glass, which means he's in jail, which means that whatever happened with this situation and this girl in the middle of the street is probably some fucked up stuff, maybe. Digging it so far. And, man, I gotta say it, but this girl's got a dunk on her, bro. Like, god damn. I gotta go back. Hold on. So we don't get, like, lost. Look at this girl. Holy. Hello.
Have to, I knew what had happened to her. I didn't load her down with questions. That girl had been through enough.
Yeah, just get in the truck. I'll drive you home.
I just stood in drive, looked in those eyes, and asked her where he was. I don't know.
Oh, that's why he's in jail, man. He beat the shit out of the guy that beat the shit out of her. Oh, oh, he didn't beat the shit out of him. Oh,
just waiting the truck.
Oh. What's up, bitch? You like to put your hands on women? Here you go. Eat this.
Well, I knocked and knocked and no one came, so I kicked in his double-wide door. I let the hammer drop before he got to that 12 he was reaching for. I didn't try to hide my pistol. I didn't even try to run. I just sat on the porch smoking one of his cigarettes and waited for the cops to come.
What a savage. Yo, what a savage. She's like, I didn't hide my gun. I didn't do anything. I just picked up one of his blunts, sat on the front porch, waited for the cops to get there, and was like, yeah, I just shot this piece of shit. Take me to jail. That's some savage ass shit, bro. Damn. And sadly, your testimony, girl, is not going to help, because at the end of the day, the law is the law. I mean, I applaud you, but, you know, a courtroom won't, so that's unfortunate.
All the whiskey scars I hear, I never found my day of justice, but come from a judge under seat.
Because if you leave it up to the justice system, that guy will end up killing that woman. That's just the brutal reality of life. If you don't intervene, that girl dies. That girl eventually dies. That girl eventually succumbs to that abusive dude. So, I mean, fuck 'em, man. More oxygen for us.
But I knew right then I'd never get hit again when he said to me,
wait in the truck. Yo, this is a good song.
Just
I like
wait
this.
In the truck.
Involuntary manslaughter, about a year in jail. That's what I would give you, really. You just... But at the same time, no good deed goes unpunished. So.
Comes to see me from time to time.
Yeah, she should come see you like every fucking day, dude, really, but yeah, that's good.
Worth the price to see a brighter side of the girl I picked up that night. And I might be here forever. It ain't paradise, that's true. But it's a whole hell of a lot better than the place I sent him to.
Hell.
Thank you.
10 out of 10, bro. This was really good. Yeah, bro, sign stamps approved. That was really good. This is the first song. What a good first impression for Hardy to make on me, because this is the first song I've ever heard by him. So yeah, that was solid. That was great. Yeah, so like, I see a girl walking down the street that just got her fucking ass whooped by her boyfriend. Maybe you fight on her behalf, maybe you don't. It just really depends. But he felt a certain kind of way about it. And when you're put in that situation, you don't really know what you're gonna do. Now if it was my loved one, right? Cause this was just a random, and he's just a really good guy. So he did this for a random stranger that he didn't know. Right. But for me, I don't really think I would go that far for someone I didn't know. I'd pick you up. I'd help you. I'd give you a shoulder to cry on. I'd probably take you to the police station. And if I really felt a certain kind of way about it, yeah, I'd probably try to whoop this guy's ass, but I don't know if I want to go to jail for you. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. But at the same time, if you don't kill this guy and you simply just whoop his ass, he's going to feel a certain kind of way about it. And he just may start beating on her even harder. Y'all remember that song by NF, Therapy Session, where he said, I have these shows and these kids come up to me with tears in their eyes. Some girl came up to me, said, her daddy likes to beat on her mama. I got so fucking mad, I asked her to give me his number. But what good would that do? He's just going to start beating them harder. Right? And that's real. That's what it is. So he probably took the best route that he knew how to take to make sure that she would never be in harm ever again. So, yeah, that was a good song, man. Like, you don't put your hands on females, and I only have one exception, really. I would never, ever put my hands on a female, and you guys already know what that exception is. If you kick me here, I don't care what the argument is about, that's too far. I don't care what the fight is about, that's too far. I will never lay my hands on you, so why you would kick me in this area, I don't know, but that is the exception. If you kick me there, all bets are off. You can slap me, you can punch me, you can hit me with a broom, you can do whatever, you can throw dishes at me, I don't care. But the second that you hit me right there, you become a man to me. You become a man to me, and I will treat you accordingly. That's just it. I will never put my hands on you because I'm a piece of shit. I have to be provoked in the worst way, and that right there, this right here, is my pride and joy, man. If I didn't have this, I'd kill myself, because there's no point in living without that for me. That's just the way I am. I'm not going to walk around in life without a penis. You know, I mean, that's important to me. So you kick me, that's it. All bets are off. Another reason why you shouldn't put your hands on females is because females have fathers. And if any father is how I would be, I don't have kids yet, but one day, if any father is like me, bro, they'll fucking kill you without a second hesitation. They will gladly spend the rest of their life in jail just so that you're dead. And especially if you don't know this female, you put your hands on a female, that female might have a boyfriend, that female has a dad, that female might have brothers. You're fucked. You're fucked, man. So, if the police don't get you, guess what? Good old American homegrown justice will. All right, so pick your poison. I didn't even think about the moms either. I'm sitting here thinking about the fucking psycho-ass dads and brothers that will gladly put you under a bridge. But yeah, the mamas are nothing to fuck with either. They'll come at you with fucking razor blades, a baseball bat, a golf club, some Vaseline, and a banana. And they will just tear you to fucking pieces. What the Vaseline and the banana's for, I don't know. I don't know, but they'll make something happen with it. Probably shove it up your ass.